Good evening. How y'all doing out there in video land? I'm about to make a video on a special lady. This is going to teach you how magnificently beautiful a conversion can be and what can happen when Jesus passes by. Let us pray. Thank you, Father God, for the woman the Bible calls Lydia. And Lydia has special gifts, Lord, and we're thankful for that. And we're thankful that her conversion experience should be a calling card for all Christians. For it's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Lydia was a woman from Thyatira. Now, if you remember, Thyatira was one of the seven churches of Asia Minor discussed in the first three chapters of Revelation. Thyatira, God didn't have too much good to say about it, but she was there, and she was what the Bible describes as a seller of purple. She sold purple cloth, which Thyatira was famous for. And it was used for all kinds of clothing and decorations, and it was very fashionable. And Lydia was very good at this. Now, Lydia moved from Thyatira to Philippi. And it just so happens that when she moved to Philippi, here come Paul, Silas, Luke, and Timothy. My point for telling you that is God is amazing at putting the right people in the right place at the very right time. And that's what he did with Lydia and Paul and all the rest of the evangelists that were in Philippi. And as you know, lots of people go to church. But you don't know exactly what they're hearing in church, and you don't know if they're getting the truth. Well, in Philippi, there was not enough men to have a synagogue. Now, that's important because Lydia, we know, was a Jewish woman because all the Jewish women in Philippi met down by the river on the Sabbath. Now, That was the way we know for sure that she was a Jewish woman, and she was worshiping on the Sabbath, and she did love God, and she had never heard the gospel of Jesus Christ. Now, Acts chapter 16 and verse 14 talks about Lydia being a seller of purple and from Thyatira and so forth. But it says, and God opened her heart to the gospel of Jesus Christ. I'm paraphrasing that. Paul was preaching the grace of God through Jesus Christ. And we know in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9, becomes really important to know. We're saved by grace through faith, not of ourselves. It is a gift from God, not of works, lest any man should boast. So Lydia had been hearing stories and sermons about God, but not about Jesus. And this was about to change. I don't know if it was Paul or Silas, or whether it was Luke or Timothy. More likely Paul, because he was the elder statesman of these four. He probably was the one preaching. And all Lydia had to do was to hear the gospel one time. God had opened up her heart. She was receptive to the gospel of Jesus Christ. And it says that she had gotten right with God, her and her household. Now, we're not sure whether that was her servants or whether it was her family. We just don't know for sure. But She wanted to be baptized, and she was. There was plenty of water there in the river to baptize her. And then she immediately did what Lydia really did well. She was so filled with the Holy Spirit that she wanted to cook a meal and to show hospitality to Paul, Silas, Luke, and Timothy. So she invited them over to her house. And they all had a grand time and probably heard a lot more preaching and a lot more teaching and probably had a really good meal. And that's really the theme of this particular video. Right now, you may be one of the people that God is putting in the right place at the right time for somebody you may not know or somebody that you do know, but you don't know that you're going to be in a position to witness to them. Now, here's the thing about witnessing. Most people say, oh, Brother Al, I can't do that. No, I can't do that. Well, when God opens people's hearts, like he did Lydia, you can do it. You can tell the truth. You simply have to do this. Make sure they know everybody's sinned. Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. And then two, make sure that they know there's a price that is paid for sin, and it's death. Romans 6:23, the wages of sin is death. And then you need to know from Romans chapter 5 and verse 8, but while you were yet a sinner, this is good news, Jesus paid your price on Calvary. Jesus paid your sin debt. So you tell people everybody's a sinner, and the wages of being a sinner is death. But there's good news. Jesus paid for your sin. And then the question obviously is asked, well, what do I do now? You receive him. For as many as receive him. John 1:12. Boy, I use that a lot, don't I? Yep. Really important. For as many as receive him, Jesus, to them gave he power to become the children of God, even to them that call upon his name. Lydia called upon the name of Jesus because God opened her heart. There's going to be somebody in your family that's going to say, Daddy, Mommy, how can I get saved? Grandmothers, grandfathers, uncles, aunts, people in the neighborhood. I mean, it's endless. God will put the right place, put the people in the right place at the right time to get salvation taken care of. Lydia, a seller of purple cloth for all kinds of clothing and probably decorations in the home. She moved from a very, very undisciplined, ungodly, unchrist-like place, Thyatira, to Philippi at a time when maybe one of the very best preachers ever after Jesus, the Apostle Paul, and other very notable good preachers, you've got Luke, got Timothy, and you've got Silas. You remember Paul and Silas at the Philippian jailer. That's that video. You know what happened there. Sirs, what must I do to be saved? Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ was the answer. That's also in chapter 16. A lot of good things come when you read the Bible. A lot of very good things come when you read the Bible. Let's thank God for this simple woman, Lydia, and the joy of salvation. Let us pray. Father, thank you for this time. Thank you for Lydia, and thank you for moving the people in the right place at the right time so she could hear the gospel. Let us be prepared to tell the people the gospel truth, that Jesus is God's plan of salvation. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you all. You have a great weekend. I'll see you soon.